Live company is David Ciclitira. David, good morning.
Good morning to you.
Good to have you back, David. This is a significant update from you this morning, the first live BRICKLIVE show since the start of the pandemic. Tell us a bit about BRICKLIVE in the park here.
Well, it's the first show. It's a very similar show to what we used to do at the NEC. So it's at a place called Evolution London, which is 5,000 square meters. Very popular venue in Battersea Park. Of course, Battersea is part of Wandsworth, very close to Chelsea, Fulham. Very good place for restarting. It's in August. It's got great content, actually fantastic content, probably the best content that we've ever had in one of these shows. Revenue comes from sale of tickets. Tickets will go on sale, I think, March 15. We've got a retail offering, and we expect that to be very, very successful. We're very excited because this is the first time that the company in 2 years will be able to welcome children and families to one of its shows and let them play and learn, which is where we all started. That's what BRICKLIVE was. We then, of course, got involved in selling and creating tours, which have been very, very successful. We've got six tours currently touring in the US right now, and this is just fantastic. And I guess it shows the way forward in terms of UK and pandemic.
That's what I was going to say. So really, this marks the start of the return to normal here for Live Company.
If you need to listen to our Prime Minister, that's what he says. So yes, we're acting immediately.
Tell us more, David, about this new zoo contract which you've secured.
Well, that's a Knowsley Zoo, somewhere we've been before. So it's a yet another return from a previous customer. It's exciting that people are waiting to get going. As I said about the Battersea Park show, this is people need content, and our content is actually a proven entity.
And that'll run over the UK summer here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, you and I, David, the last time we spoke, we were talking through the K-pop Flex festival. The first day, tickets sold out. You've now announced a second day. Tell us what the plans are.
Well, as we've said, we've announced a second day, and obviously we are finalising the final artists. It's been very, very exciting to be able to do a second day. I won't tell you today, but ticket sales are going well, and so we will be announcing, when we announce our final artist, how we're doing on tickets. But it's just exciting. It's just the K-pop.flex is, as you know, a very recent phenomenon for us. A lot of excitement, a lot of interested other venues around the world interested in being involved. But the key is to get the first one right in Frankfurt and obviously to do the best we can for the fans. What's also exciting is we're going to do a K-pop fest over that weekend. So there's now 2 days, so truly a festival. Something we wanted to do, probably we would have started next year, but you know, events overtook us, and so we're delighted. But there's more to come, so I'm sure we'll be talking soon.
Well, speaking of more to come, how's progress as far as the streaming and the merchandising contracts?
We're doing very well. We're just in discussion, as you'd imagine, and they're both significant pieces of news, so they will be released separately.
Good to catch up this morning. David, thanks very much.
Thank you very much. Bye.